I know what you were thinking, or at least I hope I know what you were thinking. Where's George? I'm here, George Mariner Mole, Artistic Director of the Discovery Orchestra. We teach the listening skills that help people emotionally connect to classical music, and through our discovery chats and in-home recitals, investigate other styles of music as well. Now, as the result of persistent conditioning, most of us cannot encounter guitar music like that you just listened to without thinking of Spain, or perhaps you might think of the word flamenco. In this discovery chat, number 26, we'll look into one of the things that makes this music sound the way it does. This style of music, often incorporating singing, guitar, drum, and castanet playing, dancing, and making very special clapping sounds with your hands, originated in the 1700s in the region of Spain known as Andalusia. The musical influences include some familiar suspects. You may remember the Roma, also known as the Gypsies, back from chat 20. But there are also Arabic, Moorish, and Sephardic Jewish musical roots to be found here. I'd like to introduce another good friend and colleague of mine, John Carlini, a multifaceted player of the guitar and banjo and composer. John, welcome.
Thank you so much, George. I'm delighted to be here and be a part of this discovery chat.
Thanks for coming this morning. Now, John, would you please play again for us the short excerpt that you played at the beginning of this chat? Now, putting aside the timbre of the guitar, which we really can't do, so great is our association of guitar with this style of music making, but there are other hallmarks which we can link to things we've already learned in these chats. Remember pedal point from just two chats ago? We talked about sustaining a single pitch while having other chords above it. Sometimes they clash. The E is repeated over and over again. Now, listen to John play this and stay focused on the pedal point, on the E that's repeated over and over again. He'll probably help us a little bit with that. Hearing that E always in there? Now, the chords above the pedal point are actually pretty simple chords. We've talked about chords on several occasions, in chat 18, for instance. But it's time to start discussing what is known as a chord's quality. By this, we don't mean, is it a higher quality chord worth, say, $5,000 more than a chord of lesser quality? No, here we're making distinctions about the sound or flavor of various kinds of chords. The most basic family of chords each have three pitches in them. These groupings of three pitches to form a chord are also known by the name triad. One, two, three, makes sense, doesn't it? Yes, triad. Each pitch also has a name. The first pitch, the bottom one, is also known as the root. Above it, the third, so named because it's three scale steps up from the root, if you count the root as the number one. And finally, the fifth, so named because, you guessed it, it's five scale steps up from the root, again, if you count the root as one. Putting it all together. Now, if we create a triad starting on the first pitch of a major scale, and we use only pitches that occur in that scale, we will create what is called a major triad or chord. We say the quality is major. Other triads have other qualities, such as minor, diminished, augmented, but all these distinctions are going to have to wait for another chat. One other thought. Any triad may be inverted, meaning what? We don't have to have the root in the bottom. Here it is with the root in the bottom. But what if we put the third in the bottom? That's called the first inversion. We could also put the fifth in the bottom. that's called the second inversion. What has all this got to do with Spanish guitar or perhaps flamenco guitar music? What has become a common, or perhaps so common even as to become a cliche musical expression associated with this Spanish guitar playing, is to sustain the pedal point and play three first inversion major triads, each a step apart from the other, above the pedal point. Now, if you have a piano, you might want to try recreating this little musical event for yourself. Pedal point and the first inversion triads above it. Now, as you listen to John, be aware of the pedal point and the successive major triads that create this sound. Now, of course, there are lots of various ways to execute or play these sounds on the guitar, and I'll leave that up to John. So, take it away, John. Thank you for that. This chat marks the halfway point in creating our first year of weekly chats. Nos vemos la próxima semana.